टूल्स ऑफ रिकॉम्बिनेंट डीएनए टेक्नोलॉजी और दैट इज जेनेटिक इंजीनियरिंग, जेनेटिक इंजीनियरिंग फॉर फॉर्मेशन ऑफ रिकॉम्बिनेंट डीएनए और जेनेटिक इंजीनियरिंग डिफरेंट टूल्स एंड टेक्नोलॉजी इज रिक्वायर्ड. The firstly we studied about the tools, so what is the requirement of the recombinant DNA technology. First is that is enzyme, different types of enzyme required for the recombinant DNA. Second one is of cloning of vector. The vector is required for the insertion of DNA, foreign DNA or foreign gene material. And third one is of competent host organism means the particular or specific type of host in which we introduce the recombinant DNA. First of that is enzymes, from which we find out the particular gene or foreign DNA. The DNA or gene or fragment will be inserted into cloning vectors that will be transferred or that prepared its copy, and competent host organism in which that recombinant DNA will be transferred, where this recombinant DNA produce its copies or its product. The first of all we studied that is of enzymes. Enzymes, different types of enzymes that require for the formation of recombinant DNA. Different types of enzymes require. First one is of restriction enzymes. These enzymes cut the DNA fragments from various locations. That is of restriction enzymes. First time restriction enzymes formed by the scientist Wilcox and Kelly. First time restriction enzyme formed by the Wilcox and Kelly scientist, that is of Hind second. It is the first restriction enzyme, or we can say that is endonuclease enzyme, which was formed by the Wilcox and Kelly. After that, 900s or more than 900s restriction enzyme find out from the various type of eukaryotic organism. The naming of restriction enzymes occur through with the following sequence. The first U word, which is obtained from the genus of the particular organism from which that restriction enzyme is isolated. That first word is of genus from which the restriction enzyme is isolated. तो जिस ऑर्गेनिज्म से रेस्ट्रिक्शन एंजाइम निकाला गया उसका जीनस फर्स्ट वर्ड लिया जाता है रेस्ट्रिक्शन एंजाइम का. सेकंड वर्ड इज ऑफ स्पीसीज एंड थर्ड वर्ड इज ऑफ स्ट्रेन, दैट इज रेजिस्टेंट स्ट्रेन और सेंसिटिव स्ट्रेन और एनी अदर टाइप स्ट्रेन. एंड फोर्थ वर्ड इज ऑफ the number of restriction enzyme which is obtained from the particular type of organism. Why first number or second number or third number? Just like E. coli R 4. Here, this is the name of restriction enzyme E. coli R 4, where E obtained from Escherichia coli. Coli is the species. R is of restriction strain. And it is a fourth number of enzyme which is found out from the particular bacteria, that is of E. coli. So in this way, the naming of restriction enzymes is done. Restriction enzymes is of two types. These are of two types. First one is of endonuclease. Another one is of exonuclease. First, we can say that the restriction endo. These are the molecular seizures. These are the molecular seizures. Restriction enzymes are the molecular seizures. These enzymes cut the DNA from various ends. So now first, that is of endonuclease. It is cut the DNA from the specific end, from the specific portion, that is of restriction endonuclease. Suppose this is the DNA, and it cut the DNA from a particular point where its sequence is there. Suppose this is the two portion, one is this and one is this. So it will be cut from the specific ends, from inner side. So that's why it is known as endonuclease enzyme. And the both ends are sticky ends. Sticky ends means, suppose here G A A T T C sequence is there. So here C T T A A G sequence is there. Any both the ends of sticky, they will having complementary नाइट्रोजन बेस पेयर. ये दोनों स्टिकी एंड्स होते हैं. इनके जो नाइट्रोजन बेस पेयर कम, दे विल अटैच टुगेदर. सो रेस्ट्रिक्शन एंडोन्यूक्लिएज एंजाइम कट द डीएनए फ्रॉम द स्पेसिफिक रीजन एंड दैट फॉर्म द स्टिकी एंड्स. अनदर टाइप ऑफ एंजाइम दैट इज एक्सोन्यूक्लिएज. इट कट द डीएनए फ्रॉम terminal positions, either from here or from here. Terminal position से exonuclease enzyme को cut करता है, DNA को cut करता है, जबकि endonuclease specific point से, inner portion से, बीच में से cut करता है. Exonuclease terminal position से cut करता है. So this is the restriction endonuclease. We studied how the endonuclease works. एंडोन्यूक्लिएज का फंक्शन कैसे होता है वो देखते हैं हम. एंडोन्यूक्लिएज एंजाइम का फंक्शन कैसे होता है, मैकेनिज्म ऑफ रेस्ट्रिक्शन एंजाइम्स. मैकेनिज्म ऑफ रेस्ट्रिक्शन एंजाइम, सपोज दिस इज द डीएनए, any DNA, and this is of foreign DNA. The same restriction enzyme cut the specific end of both vector and foreign DNA. Suppose this is a vector, this is a foreign DNA, so both are cut. If we see here, the sequence is of G A A T T C, and here C T T A A G. Again, here that sequence is of G T T A A G, and here is of C P, C A A T T C. This is the sequence. So if we utilize or we
cut the particular DNA fragments, that vector and foreign DNA, with the help of same restriction enzymes. इसको कट किए जिससे दिस इज ऑफ सपोज वेक्टर एंड इसको डीएनए विच विल बी दैट विल बी इंसर्टेड दिस तो दिस कट लाइक दिस सीक्वेंस हियर वेक्टर दैट इज ऑफ सी टी टी ए ए एंड G will be here. And like that here, that is of G, G, A, T, T, C will be here. Yeah, Mr. Harry, right? Depend. Here will be that is G A A T T C and here that is of C T T A A G. So these two ends, this one ends and this one end will be sticky ends. Whenever they come together, these both ends will be joined together. This is the different DNA. This one is of different DNA. When both the DNA cut from the same type of restriction enzymes or endonuclease enzyme, they form the sticky ends. Sticky ends means they having both having the complementary DNA nucleotide sequence, and if they will come together, they will both the portion will be joined together. So this portion having cytosine, thymine, thymine, adenine, adenine, guanine, and this portion having guanine, adenine, adenine, thymine, thymine, cytosine. That is cytosine joined with this guanine, this thymine with adenine, thymine with adenine, adenine with thymine, adenine with thymine, and guanine with the cytosine. When they come together, they will again form. This is the recombinant DNA, and then having C, T, T, B, A. A and this one is of G. Here this one is of G A P P of this. This is the recombinant DNA. In this way, the two different DNA will combine together with the help of that enzymes. That is of restriction enzyme, and especially that endonuclease enzyme is utilized. Other types of enzymes are also required, that is of restriction enzymes. Then other type of enzyme is of DNA ligase. DNA ligase that will be joined. This DNA ligase is helping the joining of two different part of the DNA. दोनों एक फॉरेन डीएनए और एक वेक्टर डीएनए, उन दोनों को जोड़ने का काम करता है. दैट इज ऑफ डीएनए लाइगेज. रेस्ट्रिक्शन एंजाइम कट करने का काम करता है, एंड डीएनए लाइगेज एंजाइम हेल्प इन द जॉइनिंग ऑफ टू डिफरेंट एंजाइम्स, सॉरी टू डिफरेंट पार्ट, टू डिफरेंट दैट इज डीएनए. एंड थर्ड वन इज ऑफ लाइसेज. लाइसेज दैट हेल्प इन द लाइसिस ऑफ सेल वॉल, लाइसिस ऑफ सेल वॉल, लाइसिस ऑफ प्रोटीन और एनी अदर मटेरियल दैट डाइजेस्ट द डिफरेंट पार्ट ऑफ द सेल्स एंड आइसोलेट दैट पर्टिकुलर टाइप ऑफ डीएनए. लाइसिस एंड अनदर इज ऑफ सिंथेटिस. सिंथेटिस एंजाइम दैट हेल्प इन द सिंथेसिस ऑफ डिफरेंट हार्मोन्स एंड एंजाइम्स एंड एनीथिंग अदर्स. सो दीज आर द different types of enzymes which is utilized in the DNA technology, that is of restriction enzyme, DNA ligase enzyme, lysis enzyme or synthetic enzymes, synthetase enzymes.
Now the next tools, that is of cloning vector. Cloning vector. What is the cloning vector? The cloning vector is the type of genome or DNA that will be carried, that particular DNA fragment, and incorporated into the host and produce the particular type of product. That is a cloning vector. These are plasmids. What is the plasmids? Plasmids presenting the bacteria, or inside the bacteria. It is not present all bacteria, but present in some bacteria other than the nucleus. It is also known as extra nuclear chromosomes. If you see the bacteria, this one is of main chromosome of the bacteria. Sometimes in some bacteria, one more circular DNA is there other than nuclear chromosome, that is known as plasmid. That is the plasmid, or it is circular DNA other than the main DNA, that is known as extra nuclear DNA, which is present in bacteria. Another is a bacteriophage. Bacteriophage is a type of virus which caused the disease in bacteria. It is the type of virus that caused disease in bacteria, that is known as bacteriophage. Means that is virus, bacteria infecting virus. Bacteria infecting virus is the bacteriophage. These are used because they have very high number of copies. Whenever these bacteria will be inserted into the host, they produce one or two copies, but that bacteria produce very high number of copy. In this way we can produce multiple products within a certain time periods. So bacteriophage is now mainly utilized. It can produce 15 to 100 copies per cell. 15 to 100 copies per cell, but the plasmid produce one or two copies per cell. That's why bacteriophage is more utilized as a cloning vector. So these are the cloning, mainly two cloning vectors in which we insert that foreign DNA and produce recombinant DNA and their product. That vector require the following things in that vector. Require vector should vector having, these are the following points. We can say the following parts present in the vector. That is of ORI. ORI means origin of replication. ORI, origin of replication. Selectable marker, ORI, origin of replication, selectable markers, and cloning sites. Cloning sites. Mainly these three parts present in each and every cloning vectors. What is ORI, what is selectable marker, what is the cloning site, we study in next class.